Hello, it's our pleasure to have with us Professor Satyanarayana Gumadi. He is a professor in the Department of Biotechnology here at IIT Madras, and he has been with us here for over 15 years now. He has considerable experience in research and a lot of success in research. His areas of research include survival of microbes under extreme conditions and exploiting this aspect for industrial applications. He also looks at molecular and biochemical basis of phospholipid translocation in cellular membranes. So these are two major areas of thrust, areas of research for Professor Gumadi. He has written several books, several chapters in various books. He is also a NASI Scopus Young Scientist Award winner in the year of 2012 in the field of biological sciences, and this is given by Elsevier, which is a body of journal publication process, which is where a lot of scientists publish. He's also in the editorial board of several journals. So you can see that he's very well qualified to discuss research with us in the area of biotechnology, and he has a lot of experience that would be very valuable for us to learn from and listen to. So thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
So let me begin by asking you this general question. In biotechnology, are there areas that are considered traditional areas of research which perhaps have been there for a while, where if you do a search you will see a lot of literature already existing and so on?
I think in biotechnology has evolved from two basic disciplines in the country. So one is from engineering. If you say it came from chemical engineering, a traditional area of research in chemical engineering in terms of biotechnology is biochemical engineering, bioprocess engineering, to develop process for production of certain metabolites, industrial valued compounds, which is replaced by a chemical process. Basically, want to convert chemical process into environmental friendly biotechnology. So that is one traditional way of approach in research in from engineering point of view. And from basic science point of view, so biotechnology evolved in MSc programs, BSc programs, where they have strong background in terms of biochemistry, molecular biology and genetics. So these two are the traditional areas of research which initially biotech started up in country. Now it became highly multidisciplinary, where it's been working with several fields of engineering and sciences in terms of research.
Okay. And in a similar sense, are there specific areas that you feel are interesting to highlight as very recent areas of research in biotechnology, where maybe which have sort of gained prominence, let's say in the last 5 years or something like that?
So, from industry point of view, production of therapeutic proteins, monoclonal antibodies, vaccines, so the drugs for human disease became a very prominent. So a big technology has taken over from traditional microbial biotechnology to animal cell cultures and plant cell cultures for production of various drug molecules. They also called as the recent term they give it is biosimilars. So biosimilars means the compounds that are similar to what we have in our body.
Okay.
For example, for blood deficiency people, you give erythropoietin. So erythropoietin is what we have it in our body.
Have it already
in our body. So we need to produce certain same compound with the same structure in vitro. Using membrane cell culture.
Okay.
So that's one of the recently taken over industrial aspects of research where large investments are going on. Secondly, in computational biology. So people are working on developing new softwares in terms of bioinformatics to find structures, structure of proteins or DNA molecules, so which in turn helpful in making drug targets and then in terms of bioinformatics. And recently, a very catchy word is coming up is a large data analysis.
Okay.
So our institute is also very famous in working on large data analysis, big group working on it one. So in which biotechnology plays one of the major role in large data analysis, because there's a huge amount of sequence data available from human genomes, so which need to be analyzed and analyzed to find out, so what could be the probable reason for a disease and all that. So these are the new recent.
Okay, very interesting. I think so that shows how maybe computing facilities are so critical for and even computational techniques that people may specialize in. So even in biotechnology, there's a lot of computation that is inherent to the research.
We have a big computational group in our department, and there's a very strong interaction between our department and the computer science people. Doing a lot of projects. And recently, we hired an interdisciplinary faculty for this area.
Very nice to know. So let me also look at it, let's say looking at it from the student perspective, when students come in here for specifically for an MS or a PhD degree, if you see, you know, incoming students based on, let's say, the backgrounds that they have or the range of backgrounds they have and so on, are there specific areas that you feel they face challenges in as they settle into an MS PhD program? Is the training that is there in traditional colleges that are out there adequate to prepare them for MS PhD, at least as they enter in here in biotechnology? Or do you see some specific lacunae that they need to address, or, and if so, you know, how are they going about overcoming such thing?
I think the new coming students, they have lack of lot of hands-on experience on doing experiments. So especially in biotechnology, all experimental people, so you need to have a lot of experience to handle a lot of equipments, to do an accuracy. So that is what lagging in them.
Okay. So, and it's probably also got to do with, I think in biotechnology, maybe the requirement for, you know, say cleanliness and, you know, thoroughness in an experiment is probably even more critical, because maybe our hands can themselves completely pollute a sample. So you may not know what culture you are developing there if you're not careful. Maybe so I think then what you're suggesting is that, you know, the it's not just maybe the ability to just start an experiment and end an experiment, but the rigor with which that experiment is being. So that is something that is people are lacking as they come in. Okay. So are there some, you know, special courses that you run which particularly to address this? I mean, how do you alert the student that, you know, they are sort of deficient in this, and how do you, you know, bring them up to the standards that you feel are required?
So I think most of us train them in the first 1 year while they do coursework and all that. So they undergo with some seniors and research scholars, do preliminary experiments. So we make sure that they are well equipped to carry out experiments in their own labs. What we expect them to do. So first year majorly we devote time for them to do this.
Of course, I mean, as you already mentioned that, you know, there are maybe specific industries that are looking at what research you do and so on. Of course, at the same time, there is sometimes this impression that an MS degree or a PhD degree has a tendency to come across as being very academic in the focus, because that is how we go about it. Because that level of focus and concentration is required to get to carry out research. And sometimes also MS and PhD research is on some cutting edge activity which maybe the society may benefit a little later from. It may not be like, you know, it's immediate. Not directly beneficial for this. So in this scenario, where do you see the industry fit in? How interested are they in what are the current research activities in the field, or how far you feel they are behind, or how far you feel they are in line with whatever is going on in the high end research in biotechnology?
So to be frank, the number of industries in biotech available now are much less compared to other fields.
Okay. Is that just an Indian thing, or internationally also you see that as a...
Internationally also.
Okay.
Because it involves high investment to do, and the success of that industry is also, probability of getting success is also very low.
Okay.
Because most of the thing in pharma drugs, you screen it, do clinical trials and get it to a compound. It takes so much investment.
So much investment, time and so many regulatory aspects.
Regulatory areas. So especially in those kind of industries, people look for very specific training,
like
protein expression, how to make mutations, how to make strain improvements, downstream processing. So job aspects in those areas are good. For example, in our department, students who are finished in bioprocess engineering, so their job placements are better compared to fields from other areas where people have to go for postdoctoral training, get more experienced in this one, then chances of getting a good jobs are high. This is so very wide and interdisciplinary. That's the problem. So people has to, some industry needs a person to be trained on that area.
Okay.
So based on their PhD problem and then postdoctoral training, might suit to that company.
Okay. So, do you see students also, I mean, given that they are doing something totally new and interesting with respect to maybe, you know, aspects that can be used in human systems and so on. Are there people opening, you know, are there people who are opening their own companies after they graduate? Do you see enough of an entrepreneurial, you know, element in this field? Or do you think, again, as you said, investment is too high and maybe therefore it's not possible? What do you...
I think 3-4 students start up entrepreneurship in our department. Okay. In collaborating with the faculty.
Okay.
So, they are in initial stages.
Okay.
So, mostly they are making a like of sensors.
Mm-hmm.
So, devices to find out, to investigate some some aspects, especially in case of disease, how to find out
okay.
if a person is having a disease or not. So, diagnostic kits. And more success story in our department is from Biotech group.
Mm.
So they started C6 Energy, a energy based company.
Okay.
From seaweeds they make energy.
Okay. Okay. From seaweed.
So
okay.
So that's more successful and well established company.
Okay. Okay.
From our department.
Okay. So there is an element
there,
of
there
this.
Is an element.
Okay. But most of the other students, I mean, so some amount go to the industry. Of course, that is, you are saying that's very dependent on their research topic and thing. And some are opening entrepreneurial ventures. What about, you know, academia? I mean, are there enough positions in academic, you know, institutions in, let's say, in India that MS, PhD students could go to? Because that's normally where many seem to go, and that's where they are desired also in many of the other departments. In your case, what do you see that?
There are a lot of openings. Lot of openings for academic positions. People who aspire for academic position is better to have more publications. During
okay.
their PhD work
okay.
and postdoctoral training abroad is highly preferential to
okay.
get in good places.
Okay.
So
okay.
then come back and
then come
join
back
us. A better way in biological department.
Okay, okay. So that's a sequence that you
sequence
that you are recommending.
Recommending
as, something
for students to come back to
come back and okay. Okay, okay, okay. And let me ask you, let's say something about, you know, how you look at progress in research. So because you have now, I mean, you have won several awards and so, and you have been very involved and you're also seeing all these journals from a much, much closer perspective because you're on the editorial board and so on. Generally, we look at, you know, the progress of students and as you mentioned, you know, the number of publications mm-hmm. and good journals and so on. Are there any other ways in which you feel you can gauge the progress of a research student? Because research is such a different setting than say coursework where it's very clear, there's an exam, there's a grade, you get the grade and people say you did well or you didn't do well. But in research, what all do you look at as a, when you see your students and you feel that, okay, this person is growing as a researcher?
The first thing that I recognize is that whether a student is sending me a paper to read.
Okay.
Saying that this so I found this paper interesting, so
okay.
can I use this one?
Okay.
That is the first symptom that he is into this field.
Oh, very nice. Okay.
So he is thinking about
the problem reading
and
something.
Reading to do it, making self dependent on this one.
And then make some judgment on the paper that it's interesting to read.
Interesting to read and all that. That's one kind of evaluation I do. And second thing is that do people come back with entirely new, different way of experiments? We have a regular set of experiments to do in our research.
Okay.
So people will come, okay, let me try something else.
Some different idea.
Some different
how
idea.
To, how to probe something.
I have to probe this thing sometime. So that makes really expand our research area.
Okay.
So some of my students did like that. So
okay.
mostly from engineering and now I'm becoming mostly a biological
okay.
researcher
okay.
in
okay.
biological
okay.
sciences doing that. So that helps in them whether they are on the right track
okay.
progressing themselves. And some of them even says that, shall we write a grant for this one? I assist you
okay, very
making
nice.
This
okay,
one.
Okay, so they have really thought much more. They,
much
they are getting confidence.
Confidence
then.
In this one.
Okay.
So there are some people I found. And then I made a routine in the lab that a student when coming to third year, final year, should make one rough draft of a proposal, give it to me.
Okay.
On
okay.
this area.
Okay.
So then we'll sit, write, correct. So we'll submit it.
Okay.
So that helps them in recommendation letter also.
Okay.
So
okay, 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 okay.
Is capable of thinking.
Okay.
I think in research, apart from publications, so looking at their behavior, how well they maintain the observation book data.
Okay. Okay.
So meeting guide regularly or not.
Mm-hmm.
So some students will regularly meet. So every day or
okay,
twice
okay,
in a day
okay,
when
okay.
they come and show the results,
okay.
want to do it. These are some of the things that we evaluate that.
Okay. In fact, I mean, since you mentioned about students meeting you regularly, what do you think is a good frequency with which people should be meeting their guides, and does it change with the time in their program? What would you suggest?
So, in my lab, I daily meet them.
Meet them daily.
Daily meet them and see them.
Okay.
So, I think in this field, that is better to have better a daily contact. See what's happening, what's going on, any problems come out.
Great. So let me wind up this discussion with one more general question for you. What advice would you give to a student who is aspiring to join an MS or a PhD program in biotechnology?
First advice will be not technical. This is general advice to any student.
Sure.
First student should try to become a team member in the group. Wherever he's trying, that's more important.
More important.
So that makes his life comfortable here. And this is also one of the parameters which is asked by all postdoctoral positions or in any company, anywhere do it, whether a person is a team player or not. So that's the first thing that they should learn in the this program when they join.
Yeah.
Second is to identify a problem as quickly as possible.
Okay.
As quickly as possible. And make lab record book, observation book very cleanly. Whatever they do, even if experiment is failed, let the show mention it's failed.
Okay.
When it comes, so results, data handling should be very proper, because it's very important nowadays, because people say that this paper is wrong, the results are wrong, we have to prove them.
Yes, yes.
And you'll be able to defend your work. Data or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
So the storage of data is very important, raw data, everything.
Okay.
That they have to maintain, and they should give a copy to guide, and they should also keep preserve
a copy
for themselves.
Okay.
So that any issues come, it should be maintained. Third is that they should be very systematic.
Okay.
So systematic in the sense, kind of making a regular timing, coming to lab to work on these things. So I think this will make them.
Okay. So these are things that they should tell themselves that, you know, these are the kinds of habits I should develop if I want to become a good researcher in any field, but including biotechnology, particularly some of these things you feel are, you know, very particular to biotechnology.
So,
and I appreciate the point on being a team player, because I think especially when people read for exams, maybe they have a tendency to read on their own or something, and then they have to get used to being a team player, and it helps them, it helps the others, and in all ways it works very smoothly. Yes.
Most of them don't even talk to their own lab people about their problem.
Their problem. Okay.
So they should talk to their members or other lab members.
Okay.
So more you talk, you get quick solution.
So internal communication is as important as external communication.
It is very important. And reading up literature is very important.
Okay.
Make update on the field.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are many websites where you can click it every day. Every week you get updates. What are the papers published on that area?
Okay.
Just keep reading it up, and have a broad knowledge on the field is very important.
Very important. Okay.
So that makes them successful in their career.
Okay. Thank you, Professor Gumadi. It's a pleasure that we could have you here. And I think a lot of insight you have given, which is very, I think, you know, very interesting to look at. And I think certainly students who are, you know, new, who are considering, who don't know exactly what they're getting into or what they may be getting into if they get into research. I think a lot of information you have shared will be very useful for them. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for giving me an opportunity.
Sure.
Thank you, Pradhan.